So now I want to introduce Emer Beamer from the Science On, who will present us with a brief and very surprising intermezzo, I can say, and that's all I do. So give her a round of applause.
Thank you very much for including us in the program. It's going to be a little bit interactive because we'll invite you all to join us to launch the D-Brain, which is what's been sitting there waiting. Before I invite the inventors to the stage, I'll give you small context. Every year, and it started in Amsterdam, we host the Global Designathon. Cities take part all over the world. The first year, 3 years ago, we had Rio de Janeiro, Nairobi, Berlin, Amsterdam, and Dublin. We're up to 25 cities signed up this year. Every continent is represented. The children tackle big problems, water, mobility, the circular economy. They come up with ideas in groups, they prototype them, and they present them to an expert panel. Now, luckily, we've been allowed to take one of these amazing designs with the support of the City of Amsterdam, part of the Maquistage program, and take it to the next level to see how could this be incorporated in the city? How could the designs go to the next level? So can I invite our inventors? They are Amalia, Tessa, Kumar Damas. Images. Yeah, and yeah, it comes here. And so I'm going to introduce all the ladies, or at least ask them questions, so they will present their idea via interview style. So coming to you first, would you tell us your name and your age?
Yes, my name is Tessa, and I'm 11 years old.
Great. Thanks, Tessa. What I would like to ask you is, what problem was your invention solving?
Well, our problem was water, and there are two big problems with water. Or you have too much water or not enough. And we were going towards the too much water problem. So yes. That's it. That's the problem.
We so also. Too much water in the city?
Yes.
Okay, great. Thank you. Coming over here, can you tell us your name and your age?
I am Shira and I am 9 years old.
Thank you, Shira. Shira's nine. And Shira, would you tell us the name of your invention?
D-Rain.
D-Rain. So it's taking rain out of the city. How did you come up with the name?
We came up with a name together.
Lovely. So it was co-creating the name as well. And now I'm coming over here. I'll do it a little bit in Dutch, a little bit in English, because Amalia is not Engels and it's Lira. But could you tell us your name and your age?
Yes, my name is Amalia and I'm 10 years old.
Thanks very much. And you're going to tell us how your invention works.
Wat wij hadden bedacht, daar is een prototype van gemaakt door Fien. Mm-hmm. En wat wij dus hadden bedacht waren stoeptegels die het water naar beneden lieten gaan en zuiverden. En dan kwam het in een bak onder de grond. En dan later kon je het met de pomp oppompen voor hergebruik. En dan kon je het gebruiken voor de afwas, om de planten mee te besproeien en om mee te spelen.
Precies, heel goed. So it was an integrated solution. The pavement tiles suck up the water, let it go through underneath. It gets cleaned on the way by shells. It gets collected underneath in a reservoir. And then you can pump the water back up again to reuse it for playing the plants or doing the washing up. So, yeah, super. Thank you, Bill. Komt goed, schatje. Ook weer in het Nederlands en Engels. Wat is jouw naam en hoe oud ben je?
Mijn naam is Rosa en ik ben 7 jaar.
So, Rosa is 7. En ik wil Rosa een bijzondere vraag stellen. Dus eerst in het Engels. Why do you think adults should listen to children? Dus waarom vind jij dat kinderen naar geluisterd mogen worden?
Ik begrijp je niet zo goed.
Zeg maar, vind jij of waarom vind jij...
Ik weet het al.
Omdat kinderen niet beslist dommer zijn dan grote mensen. En ik vind ook dat kinderen het recht hebben om ook te mogen beslissen.
Precies. Dus what she said in English is... children are not necessarily any less smart than adults. And they actually have the right to participate. And just in case you think we told her to say that, it were her own words when we asked her the question. And furthermore, we've done research and asked children all over the world in these 10 different cities who participated. And they continually said, we have ideas we want to be listened to. Adults are smarter or have more experience, but together we can make great things. So... Ja, heel leuk om inderdaad. It's very nice to give the girls already a big clap just before we go over to launch. Groot applaus voor de dames. Big clap.
So they are, I can say they're superstars already because I never saw so many cameras towards the stage this morning except for when the girls came on. So.
Brilliant, brilliant. Thank you. So now the big moment has arrived. What we're going to do is head over there with all of us. We're going to press the big red button. We gaan daar naartoe met z'n alletjes. And we gaan ook, and we will also ask a representative of the city, and she's one of the big supporters of children participation in Amsterdam, and for that we're very thankful. That's Femke. Mm-hmm. Femke Haku is going to help us launch this, which obviously we hope is the beginning of many more D-Rains being incorporated in the city. So if you want, feel free to stand up to have a better look. We're going to count down. We're going to count down from 5. We'll ask you all to join in with us. We're going to do the counting in English. Okay. It's exciting.
Yeah? Yeah. Can you do it in English aftellen?
Yeah.
Met z'n allen?
So we're going to start at 5. He is ready?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
press. Now we have to wait.
We need more hands.
Yay! So that's simulating the rain, which we collected and then pumped back up. If anyone wants to come and see it or have a go, press the button, pump water, come in the break. And maybe give a big hand of applause again for the girls.